Well, the most basic definition of a cult is basically a group of individuals with a similar view on life that join together. They believe that they gain power in numbers and try to encourage others to understand and respect their views. In most societies, cults develop a stigma that is more or less frowned upon due to their stereotype of having anti-political and unethical views.
Over 900 bodies dead and the strong smell of cyanide and grapes. Welcome to Jonestown, Guyana, where the People's Temple once lived. Jim Jones was born in the small town of Cree, Indiana, where he first picked up his religious roots. He then developed his passion to create the Christian doomsday cult, the People's Temple. The People's Temple was first established in Indianapolis, Indiana in 1955, and then moved around the states for the next 19 years. In 1974, Jones sought after freedom from the American Median Law and moved the People's Temple to Jonestown, Guyana. The People's Temple in Jonestown expanded quickly from 35 people to just over 900. Jones had a strong start to his utopian society and wished for it to continue populating. The People's Temple was no longer a religious church. It was now socialism, not Christianity. If Jonestown was a religious colony, why did it have no church, no chapel, and no place to prayer?
Very religious man. So my dad growing up, he used to be a really religious guy. Grandma used to tell me stories about how he just read the Bible to me, you know, before I'd fall asleep. Everything he did was about, you know, the religious sort of qualities to it. You know, it was just, you know, it was just what he promoted at the time. He was a religious man.
Edie? Fingers, are your fingers numb? Can you lie down? Reach the fingers out that are bothering you. Now, is the pain gone?
So, you know, Jim was a kind man who really cared about us. You know, he treated us like we were all the same and equal. Whether you're black, white, orange, or Asian, he treated us all the same. He was one of the first ones in our time to open up an interracial church in Indiana, and boy, did it pay off. When I was just a young boy, I felt neglected and left out of school. But in church, I would always be hanging out with the white kids. You know, Jimmy was a good guy, and that's why I followed the People's Temple everywhere they went.
You gonna go to Texas with me when I have that campaign?
I was just wondering whether I could go now. I'm about to go.
Why, of course you'll go. You went to Mexico with me.
When the People's Temple started out in Guyana, we only had about 30 people originally there. And it was a rough start because there's a lot of forestry and stuff. So we had to take out all the forests and make our society from the ground up. Jim couldn't have people leaving when they wanted to and not be committed to who the People's Temple was. He had to have people who wanted to come there and they would have to stay because they would have to help out, because without them, the People's Temple would be nothing.
Somebody is gonna get on the freedom train in Philadelphia. Come and I'll give you a bid. I got nothing but a pension. Don't leave your pension behind. Who else will tell you that? Who tell you I'll put you on that bus tomorrow?
How did his religion change when he got to Guyana?
He stopped focusing on scripture, and he more or less started focusing on himself. He was taking a lot of examples from dictatorships at the time. Like, he would follow suit with Mussolini, you know, people that really didn't care too much about the greater good of people anymore. It was more or less what people could do for my dad. You know, it was, he turned from his views just turned from helping people to what people could do for him.
The isolation aspect happened over a few months. We first were allowed in and we were able to send letter notes back to our peers and family in the States. But as the corruption of the society began to form, it started to be more reserved and we couldn't send any more notes or anything because he feared that this would get to the police or higher authority in the States.
So how did the cult end?
Basically, Jim led a prayer and then he forced all of the followers to drink Kool-Aid, which had cyanide in it.
So it was his power that really corrupted him and his utopian society. He began to abuse the power that he was given, and it just led to the downfall of the people he loved and the people he wanted to serve. The People's Temple began to be a punishment for people instead of somewhere they would like to go to be religious. And it began to have a stigma of being a cult instead of a religious group.
To whomever finds this note, collect all the tapes, all the writing, all the history. The story of this movement, this action, must be examined over and over. We did not want this kind of ending. We wanted to live, to shine, to bring light to a world that is dying for a little bit of love.
Well, I know that when my dad got to Guyana, he started really, he changed, like his view on women changed, like he started raping women, he started abusing drugs, just treating people like animals.
These pictures were taken just hours after the mass murder-suicide at Jonestown in 1978. 900 bloated bodies litter the ground, including those of 200 children. A barrel containing cyanide-laced Kool-Aid lies nearby. Just months earlier, the Reverend Jim Jones was preaching from the pulpit at the People's Temple in San Francisco. His followers, mostly poor black men and women, gave Jones their money and their loyalty.
I think it was something that we had to go through. You know, there's so many stories of utopian societies that didn't work, and you always think that your society will manage to overcome these circumstances, but it doesn't happen because people have points of view, people have perspectives on different issues in your society, and they begin to riot and become uncomfortable.
An audio tape recorded sometime on November 18th illustrates Jim Jones' deteriorating state of mind.
They won't leave us alone. They're now going to make us tell more lies because more congressmen. There is no way we can survive.
That day, Jones ordered his gunmen to attack the congressional party at the airport.
His cult murdered a congressman from the U.S., and either way, they were going to get caught, so he just wanted to die, have a easy death.
I tried to dive behind one of the wheels of the plane, and a lot of other people had the same idea. There were just bodies tumbling, and as I dove, I got hit in the arm, but I was fortunately able to get up and get out of there.
They would not be allowed to leave. They'd be under, Jim would probably have them all killed anyways because he had armed men there.
Did Jim die as well?
Yeah, he died by a self-inflicted gun wound to the head. He shot himself.
When life leaves you high and dry, I'll be at your door tonight if you need help. If you need help, I'll shut down the city lights. I'll lie, cheat, I'll beg and bribe to make you well, to make you well. When enemies are at your door, I'll carry you away from war. If you need help, if you need help, your hope dangling by a string, I'll share in your suffering to make you well, to make you well. Give me reasons to believe that you would do the same for me, and I would do it for you.
For you.
Baby, I'm not moving on. I'll love you long after you're gone.
For you.
For you.
You will never sleep alone. I'll love you long after you go.
And long after you're gone, gone, gone.